know who this person is. Anyway, hopefully it shows up full because I had it in the PowerPoint. For some reason, the PowerPoint won't play. But fortunately, I have it on here without the PowerPoint. So. Ladies, can you see the screen fine? He makes movies for them, and this was one of the theme songs he puts in the background. He puts his stuff together. So it was really kind of cool. But, there. Is that better?
Yeah.
There. Okay. So anyways, he did this one year, and I heard this song. It was really cool. And it is, she's a Christian artist. And so that whole song is about the love of Christ and so on. Do you, Lady, were you all here the 2 weeks ago when we had this? Is there one who's in the room here? Do you remember, and I'm not, were any of you able to sort of put into action, remember what I asked you to do a couple weeks ago? Were any of you able to do it? Did you think about doing it? Yay, nay? Yes? No? Little action, little environment, okay, a little energy? No. Yeah, and so part of the idea is what I want you to do is really listen to the action things we ask you to do. Try to carry that out, okay? I think it's really important because what you want to do is put what you're taking here, put it out there, and then you're sort of, that's the real integration of what's happening, okay? So we're continuing with charity. We're continuing with charity. And so just like did 2 weeks ago, we always want to start with the same prayer. All right, and so I've got it up here. So if we could, together, in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. God, let me play well but fairly. Let me play well but fairly. Let competition make me strong but never hostile. In this and in all things, guide me to the virtuous path. If I know victory, grant me happiness. If I am denied, keep me from envy. See me not when I am cheered, but when I am bent to help opponent up. Seal in my heart that everyone who takes the field with me becomes my sister. Remind me that sports are just games. Teach me something that will matter once the games are over. And if throughout the athletics, I don't know what's going on, but I'm kidding. It's going forward. Hang on. That's weird. What's going on with your PowerPoint system? It does? It just sort of goes on its own? Wow, that's weird. Remind me that sports are just games. Teach me something that will matter once the games are over. And if through athletics I set an example, let it be a good one. Amen. Do you have any idea why it's doing this? Wow, that's weird. Okay, so in this lesson, and again, we're dealing with charity. It's gonna just, you know, I know why it's doing it. It's set on a time. Something like that. Where's that? Where do you see it at the top? You can come here. Right here. So, in this today, what we want to sort of look at in terms of our proclamation, by playing the sport is more than just an activity, but rather an opportunity to express love. We have the ability to meet the living Christ. Okay? And so we want to look at what we're doing and know it's a competition, and competition is awesome. And we need that, and when we deal with our competitor, yeah, it's still going. Yeah, it's like it's on an automatic time that's set for a certain time, isn't it? Something within the program. I mean, I'm not looks concerned. Like I'll just keep popping back. But what we want to do is keep in mind that though we want to be competitive when we're in it, we've got to love the person too. And there's opportunities, other opportunities to love. And so you keep seeing that pop in this video, that we can love others, not just in the sport, we can take this and express it. How many of you know, are familiar with Michigan State basketball at all? Okay, so you know who Adrian Payne is? He just graduated this past year, he's a senior. I'm gonna show you this video. And I don't know if any of you know the story of Adrian Payne and Lacey Hayworth. That's what this is a video of. And so I'm gonna show you the video and it'll give you an idea of what happened in this relationship that developed. shows. I probably need QuickTime, which means I got to show it outside.
Lacey's a girl that was stricken with one of her most feared diseases, cancer.
Made it.
And I thought of a trip to the hospital that we'd do once in a while. She asked him to stick around. He did.
I haven't thought of it like this in a long time, Lacey. That's how I thought of it before you. Mm-hmm. Lacey is a special friend, and she's like a sister to me. What color do you need to know?
Pink.
Is your favorite color?
Yellow is.
Yellow. No. Which are the yellow ones?
Angel is my brother. I just think of him when I smile.
Yeah, you know, say, what are you calling? She has called me to fight through everything. To always continue to have a smile on my face, even when things are going wrong.
I have to go.
Sat there just like a guy behind the scenes and watched AP, you know, sitting in the bed with her, and mother kept saying AP, and she turned and her eyes opened for the first time in a couple of days. And it was just like her world was better.
There's days where the smiles don't come as easily, when you can walk in the room and you see her just light up. Like that, it means everything.
When he picks her up and she's way up above the world, she just feels confident and protective and just comforted. I had my moments when the mad at AP because he can do something right, and happy with him and proud of him and disappointed, all the things that go on in coaching. But the day I die, forget those couple of scenes that I was privileged to be part of thanks to him.
See, you're here. Lacey will forever be a part of my life. She's fighting something. You give her strength to get through it. You can keep her living and keep her spirits high. My journey here at Michigan State, it's been like riding a roller coaster. When I came here, I had so much growth as a person and as a player and a coaching staff that has gotten down to me.
Adrian Payne has changed as much as any player I've had. If you looked at when he came out of high school, the big question was, would anyone be able to get into college? But senior night, I think any guy wants to walk out with their mom or grandmother.
I wish they could be there. If I had to, I would stop playing basketball for them to move. But Lacey is coming with me, and for her to be able to do that just means the world to me.
He knows the level of commitment that was given to him to make sure that he's in the position he is in now, to take his life and his gifts and all that he's done, and now to use that to help other people. That's what I'm most proud of.
I'm going to be sad that he's leaving. Proud of him as a player, and maybe even prouder of him as a person.
It's kind of sad, but I'm kind of happy for him.
Say something that you want Adrian to know before he leaves Michigan State.
That I think of him all the time and I love him.
senior number 11, Keith Appling. Currently, he's second in the Big Ten Conference in assist to turnover ratio. Appling, a two-time All-Big Ten honoree, three-time recipient. Joined by his dad, Thomas Payne, and his special friend, Lacey Holdsworth.
I would just like to thank God, because without him, none of this is possible. And, you know, I'd like to thank Lacey's family and everybody for, you know, coming out and supporting me, you know, and, you know, just praying for Lacey because she's going through some hard times. And, go read the white.
Some of you said, how many of you knew the story between Adrian Payne and Lacey Abram? Right after the NCAA tournament, about a week after the little girl died. So she had a form of cancer, neuroblastoma. In fact, I had a girl, a little girl in my parish had the same cancer. She was 8 years old, and she died a year and a half ago. So really painful. Well, cancer is painful no matter what. This particular form is very painful, and when children get it. And so I think it's a beautiful act of what charity is about. Because charity starts with the ability to love someone who you don't know. And so in this story, if you were listening to what I said, Tom Izzo said they do these regular visits to the hospital. He takes his team. He thinks it's important that his team sort of these community outreach things. And there was just something happened when they went to the hospital and she was in there and Adrian met her and they connected. And they developed a very relationship through a love of a brother and sister. It turned into, you know, very special. And so even when he was playing in the championship, all of that was sort of in his own heart dedicated to her. To help her out. And to the point where, you know, the seniors at Michigan State, when they finished their last year of basketball, now I've been to the game quite often. Some of you may not know I'm a graduate from Michigan State. But when they finish their last year and they come out on the floor, they bring those closest to them, their family, what have you. And he brought her out and they come out and they kiss the S that's in the middle of the floor. It's that final game on the floor, and so they're saying goodbye. But he brought Lacey out because of this special relationship he had with her. And so she passed away. And it really speaks to he's been able to take what he does in his sport, huh? He's been able to take something that he's good at, but he took it beyond that. And he took it to share it with someone who needed some help, a little girl. You know, and it's kind of, it's a testimony as to how we, as an athlete, can help others in this world, and it's something that you ladies can do as well, you know? And so, scripture, I'm gonna do it this way rather than put the PowerPoint up, if you can see it. That's a PowerPoint, keep moving on me. Can you read that? Yeah. Matthew 19:14, Jesus said, "Let the children come to me and do not prevent them, for the kingdom of heaven belongs to such as these." You know, and so we're to share our love, not just with others around us, but there's a particular attention that God has for young children. And that to share that and express that with them is really, really helpful. Okay? I want you ladies to do, if you could just maybe just a couple of you sitting around with each other and sort of quickly discuss, go through these questions. You know, how can we use our role as athletes to inspire others? Number one. Number two, how do you think Adrian showed Lacey the love of Christ? So the story of Adrian and Lacey inspired the wider community. Why do you think that is? And then why do you think Jesus seems to place a special value on the example we give to younger people? And how might that translate into how we work with or witness to younger? Just for a couple minutes between you guys, just who's next to you and so on. There's something going on with your computer that seems to pop. Not that I want to cut you guys short and back to 7:15, but maybe we have two more minutes. I'm going to ask you if you can just sort of pull it out and just throw some of your ideas out, okay? I'm going to ask you about it so that you can hear them, okay? Cool. All right, ladies, anything you came up with any of those areas, can you toss out? What's that? Yeah. A little louder, yeah. When she said in the second question, which was, how do you think Adrian showed Lacey the love of Christ? She said when you picked up Lacey, you know, to carry out on the court, of how Christ picked up young kids, little kids. That's true. Any other thoughts, lady? Yeah. Showing good sportsmanship in the first one, I would think absolutely. That's absolutely the case. Yeah.
I'm just saying
how hard work can pay off in whatever you do. Absolutely. Anything else? How about, ladies, any thoughts on the end? Do you think Jesus seems to place a special value on the example we give to younger people, or how might that translate into how would his special value translate into what you do? Did you think about that at all? Because that's what Adrian did. Think about what he did. He literally took his gift and he transformed it from being a great athlete to caring for somebody else. That's huge. That's a big transition, you know, to be able to do that. Because he went out of himself and the selfishness of his own personal gain and play. And I'm going to say, I don't doubt it. You know, he had the opportunity to leave after his junior year to go into the pros. And he chose not to come back. He chose to come back his senior year. And I think there were multiple reasons as to why he came back. And I believe she was one of the reasons he came back. It wasn't just to win a national championship. Because had he been a pro, he would have had to leave Lansing. But she lived in the Lansing area. That's how he met her. So he would have had to leave that area. And I think that had a part to do with him staying his senior year to spend another year with her and give her his time. That's a very selfless act. Because he gave up money. Because he comes from no money. And so he was really very selfless in that relationship. Huh? You know? What I want you to think right now again with each other. Brainstorm with people you're at about how you might be able to be an example of Christ's love to someone younger than you through your role as an athlete. Okay? So do that right now. Fine? Think about a way that you personally can do this, what you can do. Be it maybe it's a brother or sister who's younger than you, or somewhere else, something else out there. So why don't you figure that out, right? Sort of look at some stuff right now. How you can actually take this into the world. Anything at all, how you can do this. Yeah. A little louder. Okay, so I'll be loud for you. Be more compassionate to your younger siblings. How many of you have younger siblings? See, I can't do that because I don't. I wish my brother and sisters were more compassionate to me. What else? Yeah. Give motivation to someone younger than you to keep them going. How many of you are older than, any freshmen here? Okay, so the rest of you aren't. What about your younger teammates? Just your younger teammates in and of itself, it's exactly what you just said. Anything else, ladies, that you can think of that you can do? Yeah. If they do a sport, what? If you can help them train, absolutely you can. Okay. What if you actually went outside yourself? What if you actually took the time to go visit someone who might be sick? Could you ever bring yourself to do that? And to me, that's a thought of an end. And I don't know if it's possible for the school to do that, sister. But I mean, something along those lines, even if it's not necessarily a younger, but to really visit those who are ill. I mean, I know the sisters have part of their thing here is a nursing care facility. Yeah?
I was
going to
say something. I'm heard some
other
nursing care
facility
here, and last year we went over to the
convent. The
convent,
yeah.
And maybe she asked me if the sisters had a blast, because they were so excited. And they get all the sisters over there, they get all the families home, they can see their ministry.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, and I know there are programs where, I know where I used to teach at Rice, we used to take the guys into the inner city and they would read, you know, to the younger kids. There are ways in which to do it where you're really going beyond your comfort zone. And ladies, it's when you go beyond that comfort zone that you really, truly expand who you are as a person. As an athlete, you're asked to go beyond your comfort zone so you get as better as an athlete, aren't you? You have to sort of stretch that. The same thing works as a person in terms of caring for others. You have to go beyond that, all right? So let's close this, because you guys might have to go in a minute. So let's close this with an Our Father, all right? In the name of Father, Son, Holy Spirit, amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Father, Son, Holy Spirit, amen. I think we may have figured out the problem with that. She says it's a touchscreen.